Giovanna have a dream to fulfill.
Friends, welcome back to yet another video of my skill series tutorial where I show you how, where and when to perform a skill move in PES 2020 on mobile. In case you guys are wondering why I am speaking in English, this tutorial already have Malayalam cheyittund and the link in the description like mele I button nokkiya mathi. So guys, today we'll be looking at an advanced fake shot skill move. It's extremely effective, it's very good in certain situations around the box as well as in the wing. And I think it's a part of gameplay that you guys need to learn, because if you don't, you are missing out on an amazing technique. It's something I have been using for a really long time. Also, I see lots of comments who watch my gameplays and live streams how to perform this first time flick. So here's the tutorial. Firstly, the basic control of a fake shot is that you have to flick the joystick as well as tap the shoot button together. That's how we do a normal fake shot when you're standing or running with the player as usual. But here the twist is that we do perform a fake shot right before we receive the ball. As soon as you make the pass, look where the space is behind your player and flick the joystick to that direction and tap the shoot button simultaneously. Can you see how I'm always ready to perform the fake shot right after I perform the pass? Now let's take a look at some of the errors that we make when we perform this one. Sometimes the flick might not be registered in the game. This happens when we are not flicking the joystick at the right time when we are performing the shoot. So to avoid this mistake or error, just make sure to flick the joystick multiple times if you are not sure about your timing. This will make sure that one of the flicks will work at the right time. You can perform this fake shot facing to any direction, flicking to any of the direction that you see you find space to burst and attack. Whether you are a defender, open defender is behind you or in front of you, you can perform this move and get into space very easily. The main reason why this move works so well is because even if our opponent think that they have us well covered, they won't let us turn or make a pass. But still we can easily get past their defenders, as their defenders will be frozen, like they are totally helpless in this situation. Now let's look at some of the best situations and timings in which we can use this skill move. Check out this goal from Kylian Mbappe that we have scored earlier. The most important detail that you have to remember is the space between your attacker and the opponent's defender. This is the clip with the most space that you can have for this skill move to work perfectly, else it could fail. Now let's have a look at this clip. Now look and think, where could we possibly go from this push? We could hold the ball, or we could pass it back to Payet, or we could pass it to the left winger who is making the run. But instead, we look for the space behind the defender where it's totally free. And hence, we go and make an easy opportunity for ourselves and make a shooting opportunity. But here, I kind of missed the chance because it's Werner. I can't expect more than this. This is extremely effective with fast players like Rashford, Kingsley Coman, Ansu Fati, Jadon Sancho, Cristiano Ronaldo and so on, because we are flicking the ball far away from the defenders and from us as well, so we need the speed to get back to the ball, else the defender will easily recover it. Next, we will be looking at a variation of this first time fake shot, that is with the cut behind and the turn skill. Players such as Lewandowski, Neymar, Kingsley Coman, Cristiano Ronaldo doesn't have it, Patrick Vieira has the skill. I should say that Lewandowski is one of the best players to do the skills because of his cut behind and turn skill and his extremely high ball control. The reason why this is so effective, as I'm saying it once again, we can easily make a turn, an entire 360 turn with this skill instead of waiting for someone else to come for a support pass or do a pass and run. Also, we can do this player with almost every player in the game. We can do it even with the goalkeeper. And it's best utilized with players with high ball control. Also, another advantage about the skill is that even if you mess up the timing, we can, if the defender behind us get the ball back, we can easily tackle them and score the goal. So guys, that's all for this video. I hope you guys learned something new in this tutorial. So if you want to see some other skill boot tutorial, please do comment below. Also, if you like my videos, please do like, share and subscribe. It helps our channel to grow faster. So until next time, peace out.